दिस इज शीतल नागर, आई एम वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ईसी डिपार्टमेंट एट आईआईएमसी ग्रुप ऑफ कॉलेज ग्रेटर नोएडा. 8086 माइक्रो प्रोसेसर इज अ 16 बिट माइक्रो प्रोसेसर. द मीनिंग ऑफ 8086 माइक्रो प्रोसेसर इज अ 16 बिट माइक्रो प्रोसेसर इज दैट ऑल द डेटा बस ऑफ 8086 माइक्रो प्रोसेसर इज ऑफ 16 बिट ऑनली. And all internal registers of 8086 microprocessor is also of 16 bits. Now, we will discuss the architecture of 8086 microprocessor. 8086 microprocessor introduced by Intel company. It is a 16-bit microprocessor, and 8086 microprocessor have 20-bit address bus. Means what is the meaning of this 20-bit address bus? It can address up to 1 MB memory locations. As per the formula, memory size or access of a microprocessor to the memory location, which is equal to 2 to the power n, where n is the number of address bus. From this formula, we can get the memory locations that a microprocessor can access. Hence, in 8086 microprocessor, as we have 20-bit address bus, means we can access up to 2 to the power 20 memory location, that is 1 MB, with the help of 8086 microprocessor. It can support up to 64K input-output ports. In 8086 microprocessor, as we have 16-bit data bus, means we can support up to 64 KB input-output ports with the help of, again, the same formula. If we have n is equal to 16, that is the data bus for 8086 microprocessor, means 8086 microprocessor can support 2 to the power 16, which is equal to 64 KB input-output ports. It provides 16-bit registers, means in 8086 microprocessor we have all 16-bit registers, word size of 16 bits and double word size is 4 bytes. For 8086 microprocessor we have a 16 bit word size and double word size of 32 bits, means 4 bytes, as 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. It has multiplex address and data bus. In 8086 microprocessor, we have multiplex address and data bus. Why we do multiplexing of address bus and data bus here? Because we have to reduce the number of pins in 8086 microprocessor. If we don't multiplex these address and data bus, the number of pins can be increased in 8086 microprocessor. Means if we have 20 pins for address bus and 16 pins for data bus, means total 36 pins are required for only buses, means address bus and data bus. With the help of this multiplexing, the multiplex process, we use 20 pins instead of 36 pins. With the help of multiplexing, we multiplex address and data bus, which is represented by AD0 to AD15. Now, 8086 is designed to operate in two modes, minimum mode and maximum mode. Basically, 8086 microprocessor, it uses two modes. First one is minimum mode and maximum mode. For this mode, we have different pins also. And in the IC of 8086 microprocessor, we have a pin which is used for 8086 to work in the minimum mode and maximum mode. It can prefetch up to 6 instruction bytes from memory and queue them and on speed up instruction execution. In 8086 microprocessor, we divide the architecture of 8086 into two groups. That is, first one is work interface unit and next one is execution unit. Means in first unit, that is work interface unit, we use a 6-byte instruction queue on microprocessor itself to speed up the instruction execution. For example, in 8085 microprocessor, if we execute a instruction from memory, then we execute or we fetch the instruction-wise in 8085 microprocessor. But in 8086 microprocessor, we have a 6-byte instruction queue on the architecture on the chip of 8086 microprocessor. With the help of this instruction queue, we can speed up the execution time of our instruction. Means our program will execute in a very fast way. Time will be used for the execution of any program will be less with the help of this 6-byte instruction queue. Now, why this instruction queue is of 6 bytes only? It may be of 4 bytes, it may be of 8 bytes. But in 8086 microprocessor, why this instruction queue of 6 bytes only? Because in 8086 microprocessor, we have a maximum size of an instruction of 6 bytes. Means, as per in 8085 microprocessor, we have a maximum size of an instruction is 3 bytes. Means we have 1 byte instruction, 2 byte instruction, and 3 byte instruction. But in 8086 microprocessor, we have maximum size is up to 6 bytes. That's why our queue to hold a whole instruction of maximum size is of 6 bytes only. It requires, 8086 microprocessor requires plus 5 volts power supply. It is a 40-pin dual inline package. Means in 8086 microprocessor is a 40-pin IC with dually packaged IC. Address ranges from, as 8086 microprocessor is a 20-bit address bus, it has a 20-bit address bus which ranges from in hexadecimal order from 00000H to 5 times FH. Intel 8086 architecture, internal architecture. In the architecture of 8086 microprocessor, the whole architecture is divided into two parts. First one is bus interface unit and next one is execution unit. In bus interface unit, we have memory interface, which is the outside memory from the microprocessor, and we have a summer to calculate the physical address for the memory. Because in 8086 microprocessor, we have all internal registers of 16 bits only, but our memory address, physical memory address of 20 bits. We have to calculate physical address with the help of segment registers and offset registers. These offset registers of our instruction pointer and source index register, destination index register, pointer registers, and our general purpose registers also. In bus interface unit, we have a 6-byte instruction queue on microprocessor chip also, which is a 6-byte long queue, as we discussed earlier. And in execution unit, we execute these instruction which is fetched by bus interface unit instruction wise in the control system. We decode the instructions and we execute as per the instruction. The execution unit. Okay. Now, as we already see in the architecture of 8086 microprocessor, 8086 health, two blocks, bus interface unit and execution unit. The bus interface unit handles all transactions of data and addresses on the buses for execution unit. Means all the data, all the instructions from the memory, which is handled by bus interface unit only. With the help of bus interface unit transfer these data or instruction to execution unit, and execution unit, as per the instruction, as per the data, execute or process the program or instructions. The bus interface unit performs all bus operations such as instruction fetching, reading and writing operand for memory, and calculating the addresses of the memory operands. The instruction bytes are transferred to the instruction queue. Means bus instruction queue, bus interface unit first fetch the instructions in queue. After that, execution unit will execute all the instructions. A bus interface unit contains instruction queue, segment registers, instruction pointers, address also. And execution unit contains control circuitry, which is used to generate the control signals also, as per the decoder, instruction decoder, arithmetic and logic unit, flag registers, pointer and index register. Now, next, the main unit of bus 8086 microprocessor is execution unit. Execution unit, it has three main works. First, it decodes instructions fetched by the bus interface unit. It generates control signals and executes instructions. The main parts of 8086 microprocessor execution unit are, first one is the control circuitry, next one is instruction decoder, and the last one is ALU, arithmetic logic unit. Control circuitry generate the control signal as per the instruction, and instruction decoder decode the instruction which is fetched by instruction queue to execution unit, and the ALU, arithmetic logic unit, process the data which is fetched by instruction queue and as per the control signal also. Execution unit. Execution unit contains the general purpose registers. In execution unit, we have general purpose registers named as AH, AL, BH, BL, CH, CL, DH, and DL. When we use these registers for 8 bits, we represent these registers like AH and AL. But when we use this register for 16 bits, we represent it by AX. And this AX is the accumulator for the 8086 microprocessor. In this case, H and L represent the 8 bits, and L represent the 8 lower bits of whole 16 bits. Register AX is used for as an accumulator for 8086 microprocessor. Register BX is a 16-bit register, means when we take the combination of BH and BL, which both are the 8-bit registers, we can use as BX, base register also. It is used as base register for the offset address also. Now, CX is used for the count and the string operations also. And this is a 16-bit register also. Now, next is the DX register that is used for data. And we have two pointer registers. First one is the stack pointer, and next one is the base pointer. In 8086 microprocessor, we have two index registers. First one is the source index register, and next one is the destination index register. These registers is also used for physical address calculation of the memory in A086 microprocessor. Now, these are the different registers as we discussed, and these are the purposes for this register. Number one, AX. Register AX is used for word multiply. As in 8085 microprocessor, we don't have any instruction for multiplication and division. In 8086 microprocessor, we have instructions for multiplication and division also. So hence, a register AX is used for word multiplication. And with the help of register AH and AL, we can byte multiply also. Register BX is used to store the address information. Register CX is used for loops and string operations. Register CL, which is used for rotate and shift operations. Register DX is used for word multiply, word divide, and indirect input-output functions. Now, pointer and index registers. Pointer and index registers are used to store the offset addresses of A086 microprocessor at the time of physical address calculation. It is used in various forms of memory addressing. In 8086 microprocessor, our memory is divided into four segments. These four segments are the part, or these four segment registers are the part of bus interface unit. With the help of these segment registers and offset registers, we can calculate the physical address for 8086 microprocessor memory addressing also. Now, in the case of stack pointer and base pointer, the default reference to form a physical address is the stack segment. Stack segment will be discussed under the bus interface unit also. Now, the next one, the index registers, that is source index and destination index. And register B externally default to the data segment register and represented by DS also. Now, stack pointer is used with the stack segment to access the stack segment part of the memory. Means, if we address the stack segment of our memory location, we can take stack pointer as the base address or offset address for the calculation of physical address of a memory with the stack segment registers. Next one is the base pointer. Base pointer primarily used to access data on the stack, and it can be used to access data in other segments also. Now, next one is the source index register. Source index register is required for some string operations. And the destination index register is also required for string operations, and these two registers also used with the segment registers, and mostly we use with this extra segment register and data segment register to calculate the memory location, physical memory location. Now, next one is the flag register, which is the most important register of 8086 microprocessor. The flags of 8086 microprocessor are set or reset with the help of or by the operation which is performed in arithmetic and logical units. In 8086 microprocessor, we have a 16-bit flag register. And in these 16-bit flag register, we have same 8 bits as in 8085 microprocessor, and other 4 additional flags like overflow flag, direction flag, interrupt flag, trap flag. These 4 are the additional flex in 8086 microprocessor means D0 to D7 same as in 8085 microprocessor, and from D8 to D15 we have additional flex for 8086 microprocessor. Means total our D0 to D15 microprocessor flag registers are carry flag. Next one is undefined flag. Next one at the D2 position, that is parity flag. Next one is the auxiliary carry flag, zero flag, sign flag, trap flag, interrupt flag, direction flag, and overflow flag. Hence, we have 9 active flags in 8086 microprocessor, and in which we have 3 control flags and 6 condition flags, which are the status flags, as same as in the 8085 microprocessor. Now, different flags and the purposes of these flags. Carry flag is same as in the 8085 microprocessor. Like carry flag will be set if carry will be generated, and parity flag is set when the parity is even, otherwise it will be zero or reset. Auxiliary flag holds the carry after addition or borrow, subtraction between the position 3 and 4. Means at the nibble position, if carry is generated, then this flag will be set, otherwise reset. Now next one is the zero flag. Zero, if result is zero, if the arithmetical and logical operations result is zero, then zero flag will be set, otherwise reset. Next one is the sign flag. It holds the sign of result after an arithmetical and logical operation. When S is equal to 1, it shows negative, and if result is positive, then S will be equal to 0. Now, trap flag. Trap flag enables the trapping through an on-chip debugging feature. And interrupt flag. Interrupt flag is used to control the operation of interrupt request pin. INTR interrupt request pin. When I is equal to, any interrupt flag is equal to 0, then INTR pin is disabled. When interrupt flag is 1, then INTR pin is enabled. Now next one and last one is our direction flag, which is a control flag. It selects either the increment or decrement mode of destination index or source index register during the string instructions. Overflow flag occurs when signed numbers are added or subtracted. This is the last one flag of 8086 microprocessor, that is overflow flag. If the result is overflow, an overflow indicates the result has exceeded the capacity of the machine, then overflow flag will be set. This is this overflow flag mostly set with the multiplication operation only. Now these all the registers of 8086 microprocessor. Thank you.